not sure why everything's going to be on the fritz today. This is my second attempt to get the live stream up and running. Alright, so let's see. Just to make sure. Yeah. Mission 5, assaults in the control room. I've technically already started this, so we've got a checkpoint that's saved that I'm going to be going right into. It looked like I had an error from my microphone earlier, but looks like everything should be working fine. Keyword being should. Don't have any viewers right now, so... Normally I just kind of do a quick recording on everything and make sure that at least my OBS isn't screwing up. And... literally moments before I tried going live, everything was working fine, and then immediately decided it was not going to work. So that's always fun. Anyhow, let's go ahead and get started. There's not really anyone watching, but hey, these things happen. And we're just keeping on legendary since I've already started the run. So I haven't really done too much here. In fact, what I got. So, you land there, you fight your way all the way over here, and that's about all that I've done so far. The assault rifle's kind of useless. It has its uses, but it's not very good against shields. And since the main thing is shields, well... and I've already died once here. Probably a couple of grunts up there. Just as long as no one throws a grenade over here. Well, okay, that makes it easy. I don't think there's going to be anything too much of use. And this part, if I remember correctly, is actually glass. And I think it can break? I'm not entirely sure. Nope. Okay. So at least I don't have to worry about that. Let's see. Lots of vehicles in this.
Enemy! The Covenant presence here is stronger than I anticipated. They seem to have the entire region secured.
Any better weapons? No. Okay. And another checkpoint.
Interesting. The weather patterns here seem natural, not artificial. I wonder if the ring's environment systems are malfunctioning. Or if the designers wanted the installation to have inclement weather.
This is Fireteam Zulu requesting immediate assistance from any UNSC forces. Does anyone copy? Over.
I didn't think there were any human forces left on this side.
Cortana to Fireteam Zulu. I read you. Fireteam Zulu, this is Cortana.
Well,
hold position. We're on our way.
Roger that. Make it quick.
Pistol is just too good. Not like that, though. Okay, so there is a Banshee somewhere over there. And hopefully I don't have to worry about it. How many shots does it take? Jeez. Ow. Certainly could have gone a whole lot worse. Don't really need to kill this guy at all, but sometimes it's just nice. And I'm gonna regret that immediately. Yeah, figures. Serves me right. I'm gonna stand over here. was a better player, I probably wouldn't have gotten hit. At least by the hunters. All the coulda-hads coulda had full health, but no, had to blow it on the hunter. And probably more stealth. That could be really bad. Is he dead? Yes, he is. And another checkpoint with explosions. Oh, I can't reach him. I think everyone's already dead. Wow, that actually hit. That was close. I need a new weapon. Grenades, probably all at the beginning. Oh, here's one. Let's just carry these two all the way over to the checkpoint. at least this way I won't have to go all the way back if I run out of ammo on one. Ow. I'm pretty sure all the Marines that were over there were dead long before I'd have a chance to get to them. That's just kind of how this difficulty goes. I kind of feel like I'm in a stalemate type position, but... That works. I'll take that. But I am gonna need another weapon. That is the... boring part of this, I guess, is that because I can't just throw myself over and over and over again, kind of like you can co-op, as long as you have one person hanging back, you slowly start running out of bullets and ammo real fast. I can still die to just a random shot, but one of the vehicles is down. I think those guys are all dead. So I'm gonna stick over here. And that guy's dead. Now it looks like there's a ghost over there that I might have to deal with. And... going to say tanks are far more formidable in this than they are in any of the other Halos, I think. At least my opinion. You don't get the that guy's down. Ow. here comes another ghost, I think. Is that a ghost? No. It's just the tank. Okay, I'm probably gonna go duck in over there at the tunnel, just so I can get another checkpoint. Otherwise, I gotta kill all those guys all over again if I screw this up. So that's what I'm gonna do. I still got one guy that can take out my shield. I don't think that actually gave me a checkpoint. It just may have just loaded it, but whatever. I'm kind of conflicted now. Do I take the rocket launcher, or do I take the sniper rifle? I mean, I can kind of snipe with the pistol, but let's face it, the sniper rifle is far better when it comes to that. And I do have three more shots. So I have a total of 5 shots. Okay, and let's see what I get with the sniper rifle. Both are tempting. Both are very, very tempting. I think I'm just gonna go with this. I know there are more tanks out there, and I'm probably gonna regret this to one. In one way or another, but actually, right. Instead of taking the Warthog, because I don't think I'm gonna be getting any Marines. Oh, hey, there's more rocket launcher. Well, then that changes everything. I am going to take the rocket. And I am going to take this little ghost. Okay, so 9 shots. Should be a tank over there. sucks and you can't lock down now, just... That's kind of funny though, having the shield guy shoot his own guy. I could probably just try and jump into the tank, but I'm pretty sure I'll get screwed up before I get the chance to actually use it. Unless I can take out some of these shield guys. The shield guys will actually charge their shots, the grunts don't. Oh, hey, look, more rockets. I think the tank is pretty much indestructible in this one too.
Yeah.
could go down that way, or I could go this way. Let's see what happens if I go this way. I can't remember how this entire mission goes.
Covenant placed their tanks to defend the entrance to the tunnel.
Too close for comfort. Okay, maybe wait for another shot. I'm just gonna wait over here. Actually, did I get my rockets reloaded? I did. Okay. I'm gonna go replenish those rockets real quick. Because I feel like I'm gonna need every single shot I can get. Especially if I keep missing. Some grenades here. Okay, all full. Should be fine now. There's probably these more guys over there. In fact, I can see one. Not sure if I can hit him. No, the tree won't let me. Somebody put a tree in my way. And he's still alive. think there's hunters here. At least all he did was damage my shield. Dead? Okay, well, that one's dead. I assume the first one's dead down here. Oh yeah, that's right, there's a tank on top. It's sitting like right up there somewhere. Now to go for the bridge. There's a turret right over there, so... Gotta take it out? Yep. Thankfully, you can't really seem to hit me, so... Now it's down. Biggest thing is to make sure it's flipped, because apparently they can't flip it. little bit sluggish, but I don't remember everything on this level. Sometimes those ghosts are a bit more annoying than that. I know the infantry is going to be, especially with this weird angle. Close. should be a couple banshees and a tank, if I remember correctly. And so I can hit this turret without triggering it. There it goes. Oh shit. There's the banshee. I think there was only one. And that's why I try not to move too fast. If I do, I just end up dying. So, this time we're going to get out. We're going to do it this way. before I get too far. That should be death 29. Stop the tank. I think there's guys over there.
I thought the Covenant had eliminated all the Marine forces in this area.
Right there. Okay, so one of the few things I guess many things.
I thought the Covenant had eliminated all the Marine forces in this area. I thought the Covenant had eliminated all the Marine forces in this area. We need to get up this ridge.
Marines, hold your positions. We'll handle those guns.
Master Chief, we should scale the ridge and get below those stationary guns.
Roger! Hold here and cover the Master Chief!
Wait, I can't see.
Thank you.
need to get up this... Get up this ridge.
Marines, hold your positions. We'll handle those guns.
Master Chief, we should scale the ridge and get below those stationary guns.
Roger! Pull here and cover the Master Chief!
Thank you.
Resistance appears to be increasing. We must be close to the control center. Analyzing. This must be the control room. The entrance to the control center is at the top of that pyramid structure. Bring me up there and I should be able to get us inside. Analyzing. This must be the control room. Subtle. The entrance to the control center is at the top of that pyramid structure. Bring me up there and I should be able to get us inside. We'll be right back. control center is located at the top of the pyramid. Let's get up there. We should commandeer one of those ghosts. We're going to need the firepower.
Thank you.
Janet. Covenant forces in the vicinity have been eliminated. Let's move on to Halo's control center. This is it, Halo's control center. That terminal, try there.
You all right?
Never been better. You can't imagine the wealth of information. The knowledge, so much, so fast. It's glorious.
So, what sort of weapon is it?
What are you talking about?
Let's stay focused. Halo, how do we use it against the Covenant?
This ring isn't a cudgel, you barbarian. It's something else. Something much more important. The Covenant were right. This ring... it's Forerunner. Give me a second to access. Yes, the Forerunner built this place, what they called a fortress world, in order to... wait. No, that can't be. Oh, those Covenant fools. They must have known. There must have been signs.
Slow down. You're losing me.
The Covenant found something. Buried in this ring. Something horrible. And now, they're afraid.
Something buried?
The captain. We've got to stop the captain.
Keys?
What are we... weapons cache he's looking for. It's not really... we can't let him get inside.
I don't understand.
There's no time. Get out of here, find Keys, stop him. Before it's too late!
Dropship was from this area. That was over 12 hours ago. When you locate Captain Keys, radio in, and I'll come pick you up.
Captured by Hawkins. heck you're not turning me into one of those things! I'll blow your brains out! Get away from me! Don't touch me, you freaks! I won't be like you, I'll die first! Find your own hiding place, the monsters are everywhere! Play dead! That's what I did, play dead. They took the live ones. Oh god, I can still hear them. Monsters! Just leave me alone! Sarge, Mendoza, Bassini. Oh god, the things took them. Away. They're gone! Get it? Gone! They won't get me! Oh god, I don't want to be like them, please. Leave me alone.
This old stuff, Sarge.
Watch your mouth, son. This stuff is your history. It should remind you grunts what we're fighting to protect.
Hey, if the Covenant want to wipe out this particular part of my history, that's fine by me.
Yeah,
better it than us.
You ask them real nice next time you see them, Vicente. I'm sure they'll be happy to oblige.
LZ looks clear. I'm bringing us down.
Go! Stay close, Jenkins! Mendoza! Move it up! Wait here for the captain and his squad, then get your ass inside.
Sir!
Okay, let's move!
Which is weird, right? I mean, look at it. Something scrambled the insides.
What's that? Plasma scoring?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe there was an accident, you know, friendly fire or something?
What do we have, Sergeant?
Looks like a Covenant patrol. Badass elite units. All KIA.
Real pretty. Friend of yours?
Nah, we just met.
Right, well, let's get this door open.
I'll try, sir, but it looks like these Covenant work pretty hard to lock it down.
Just do it, son.
Yes, sir. I got a bad feeling about this.
Boy, you always got a bad feeling about
Captain
something.
Sarge, can you hear me?
What's going on,
soldier? He's got contact! Lots of them! But they're not Covenant! They're just tearing through us! What the fuck? No!
Corporal! Do you copy? Over! Mendoza, get your ass back up to second squad's position and find out what the hell is going on.
But...
I don't have time for your lip, soldier. I gave you an order.
Sarge! Listen!
What is that?
Where's that coming from,
Everywhere.
Mendoza?
I don't... There! Mira!
Hold still! Hold still!
Let him have it!
Ah!
We're surrounded.
God damn it, Jenkins! Fire your weapon!
There are too many, Sarge!
Don't even think about it, Marine.
Oh, this is loco!
Jenkins!
the RV point, and then these things, they ambushed us. We gotta get out of here.
There's a large tower a few hundred meters from your current position. Find a way above the fog and foliage canopy, and I can move in and pick you up.
Thank you. Greetings. I am the monitor of Installation 04. I am 343 Guilty Spark. Someone has released the flood. My function is to prevent it from leaving this installation, but I require your assistance. Come, this way.
Chief, I've lost your signal! Where'd you go? Chief! Chief!
We must collect the index before we can activate the installation.
I'd say averaging two missions a night so far has been pretty good. All things considered, I was actually expecting to have way more deaths, especially on some of those parts. I haven't had a full, true stalemate just yet. I've had pretty close calls, though. But I'm going to have to push through the library, and there's one other mission that comes after that, I think, that's also exceptionally annoying. You have to go save Captain Keyes again. Except now you're fighting the Covenant and the Flood. And I'm still not quite sure on what the best loadout would be to have for that, especially solo. Because with the Flood, the human weapons work best, but it tends to be better to have like a shotgun or assault rifle, specifically for those. And then against the Covenant, it's better to have the more energy-based, if you had to choose one, so you want to use their own weapons against them. Perhaps not necessarily the Needler, because there's usually so many of the shield guys that they just bounce off, so you can't land them on hardly anyone except for maybe the Grunts, and occasionally an Elite that's just acting a bit stupid or standing out in the opening long enough. because if there was ever a part where the pistol combination is not going to work, it's going to be on these next two missions. The reason why the pistol combination works so well against the Covenant is because you can break their shields with the plasma pistol after you charge it. I don't even think it needs to be fully charged at the same time. And then you can switch over to the pistol, and especially if you can land a headshot, it usually only takes like one, but it kind of depends on how far away you are. So I think after I get past those two, there will still be some hard parts for sure coming up, like the final mission, or not the final mission, the mission just before the final, because you do the same assault on the control room, except in reverse order and with a few extra locations. And the problem is that you have to destroy the energy source or something like that by standing inside it and overloading it with your shields. Well, that takes down your shields, and then you have reinforcements that basically show up and start attacking you. And you don't always have time to even start recharging your shields. At least on Legendary, and I'm sure it's the same for some of the other difficulties, but on Legendary, it seems like as soon as your shield goes down, you get shredded so fast. I know it's kind of the same way on the other difficulties, but I think it's just a slightly greater degree. It's just more so that your shields get shredded so much faster. And without landing headshots, you do a bit less damage. At least I think that's how it's working. And I think Halo 1 has skulls, but I couldn't tell you where they are for the life of me. Because I think they've had the skulls since Halo 1, but they were exceptionally well hidden and with everything else going on. And since I don't know where the skulls are, if they are in this game, I can't even think about even doing a challenge like trying to do Legendary All Skulls or something like that, because I'm just not that good. I certainly haven't been practicing Halo at all. And it's been at least a year, maybe a couple years, since I've last picked this particular game up. But I'm glad to see that I still remember quite a bit for doing this small little personal challenge of mine. And hopefully people find it enjoying. I know there's not that many people have been watching it live. But for everything I can do, I think I'm going to try and have all of the live streams I do, at least all the successful ones I do, archived. I did have a little bit of problems tonight trying to get things going and set up. It only took me 2 tries tonight, more so if I ever go back, so I can keep track of what kind of issues and when, I guess. But the first time, it didn't look like it was connecting up to Facebook for the live stream, since there's a separate little page you have to go for that, especially at least doing it like through OBS and all that. So it didn't look like the signal was going through there. I finally got to go on that, and it looked like everything was working on OBS. So I went to go start and go live, and I kid you not, within probably those 10-20 seconds, because I had the intro set up, which has a little title card while I make sure last minute things are in place. It's like on OBS, you can have like a scene collection, so I have a small selection of different scene collections, if you would, like for when I'm doing co-op or with Kermog, or I'm doing it solo like this, and then I got other things set up in case I ever get to that point, I guess. Which is kind of the reason why I have this little setup here. I actually do have it set up so if you follow And it should do the same thing for likes and shares. I'm not sure about everything else, especially since I'm not part of the Facebook gaming stream service thing, like kind of like Twitch, where you become an associate and then a partnership. I think it's a level-up program. I think it's what they call it. I haven't looked too much into it since I'm a long ways from there anyway. But I do have things set up so that way if you do happen to do those actions, a notification should pop up. And at least from everything I can test anyway, it looks like it should work. There was one that it might have been on me because I might have had the computer volume down low while I was trying to get everything else going. So it might have been my fault on one particular one, but as far as I can tell, it looks like everything else should work. There should be a little noise that pops up for likes, follows, shares. At least those three are set up. And I do have some custom stuff that I have made specifically for those, I guess, little assets that I have. For the most part, I have nearly all of them, at least on the page that I've been using for the screens. And I'm sure I'll make more in time. It just all takes time. Unfortunately, I'm not to the point where I can have a good schedule, but that's just between life, school, and work. And when I do these streams, I try and get them as long as I can, not for any particular reason except for my own, and that is simply that for me, sometimes for particular games, it takes a while before you really start getting into it. Halo isn't one of those games that it takes me a while to get into it, but I'd really like to try and do one mission from start to finish. And I know that's not always going to happen, but if I can, so long as I have time, I will try and do that. And I will certainly try and do that for any given game that I can, but things happen. Sometimes you run into a far more difficult spot, or you just have really bad luck. And in my case, sometimes you're just not nearly as skilled as you probably should be to try and undertake certain things. And some of the shots that I've taken, like whether it's like little snapshots or whatever, some of those are skilled where I did intend to hit that and everything, and other times it's a bit more luck in the sense that, oh hey, I actually landed that hit. Cool. Take the rocket launchers for instance. They're not the best compared to other rocket launchers and throughout the rest of the Halo series, at least in my opinion. Because you certainly have to make sure you have the manual shot. And I missed. And I ended up taking a death because of that. Now on the bright side, I didn't blow myself up with a rocket launcher, so I am glad to say that. Because that would be a little bit embarrassing. But hey, heat of the moment. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the show. And hopefully it'll be soon I will be able to stream. I can't say it'll be Halo or another co-op run with Kermog. We still have Left 4 Dead to finish up. And I will probably end up doing something like with Kingdom Hearts sometime in the future. I'm not really sure on what I plan on doing after I finish my Halo run or the Left 4 Dead on the co-op. So I'm going to have to come up with something to do after that, and hopefully it's just as entertaining, far more than this one, because I don't know. Halo, I thought it would be a bit more, action-y, but because of the way I have to play, I have to be far more cautious, because I'm not trying to rack up the deaths on purpose or anything like that, and just running in headfirst, reckless abandonment, isn't really the best way to go about it on Legendary when you're solo. When you're in co-op, you can do that and still make progress. But on solo, not so much. who knows, I might move on to Halo 2 after I finish this, or I might take a small break and choose another game to play. It all kind of depends. I gotta make sure that some of the older games, especially if I haven't touched them in a while, still work. It means, oh, so many of my games are CD-based, especially for like the old Xbox and stuff. I don't have like any downloads or anything like that, or emulators. So far, everything I've played is stuff that I happen to own, and the only thing I've done maybe is make sure that it still works. It still pops up and plays. But I hope you enjoyed the show at one point or another, whether it's just watching it die or just nostalgia. And see you next time.